Your bullet journal is a great place to keep track of everything from your spending to your exercise routine. So today I'm explaining the basics of some different journal trackers and showing you mine. Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Shayda Campbell and I create watercolor, bullet journaling, and lifestyle videos for YouTube. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. Okay, so last year in 2018, I started my very first bullet journal and I sort of chronicled that throughout the year with all of my Plan With Me videos. In 2019, I've really streamlined what I want my bullet journal to be. I've got a bit more of a formula. You can still keep up with that in my 2019 Plan With Me's that come out every month. But I've also been adding additional bullet journaling tutorials like this one that we're doing right now. And what I wanted to talk about today is how different trackers work. I've gotten some questions about it, and I myself have gotten really into tracking basically in 2019. I do a daily tracker or a weekly daily where I'm tracking like, am I drinking enough water? Am I going to the gym? Am I getting up early every day? And then I started doing a larger monthly tracker for February. I think it does bring up some questions about how they work and how they differ. So we're just gonna do a quick run through today. So here is my Baron Fig journal. This is the notebook that I am bullet journaling in for the year 2019. And I will flip to my weekly spread for this week. I am filming right now. It is Friday the 25th. And you can see in the top left-hand corner, I have a little tracker. And it is sort of a way for me to keep track every day of these five things that are important to me, important for my mental and physical health. So what I am doing is tracking if I wake up at 6:30, whether or not I go to the gym, post on social media, drink enough water, and don't use my cell phone for the first hour of the day. Now, I haven't put in the data for yesterday, so you can see me putting it in here. I didn't drink enough water, so I'm gonna leave that one, and I did all the other things. I also do a half slash if I don't go to the gym, but I go for like a long walk. So these are just the things that are important to me that I kind of want to keep track of on a weekly, daily basis. This has been a really simple tracker, and it fits perfectly into my weekly layout. Like, it doesn't take up a lot of space, so I love that one. Now, if I flip over here to my February section of my planner, you can see I've done a habit tracker for the entire month. So a little more comprehensive, more healthful items on there. But as you can see from my February weekly layout, the first one I've done, I still am gonna include that daily tracker in there. I just like it, it's so easy to keep. But since I've been enjoying it so much, I thought, why not try a larger habit tracker for the entire month? And this one I showed how I created it in the February Plan With Me. So I will link that video below, but we're gonna kind of get into the nitty gritty of it today because I got so many questions about it. So what I've done here is listed more items that are really important to me and that I wanna keep track of, like, am I doing some yoga or stretching? Am I meditating? Did I do some reading or listen to an audiobook? Because I'm not using that one right now because it's not February yet, I'm gonna do a fake one in my old journal so we can go through it. So I've listed all these things. I've listed the exact same things here that I have listed on the larger habit tracker. And then all I've done is put these little dots, and you can either do it for a week or a month or whatever. I'm gonna pretend to do a week here because I just don't wanna do a bazillion dots. So I've counted out 7 squares, and each item on the list of self-care things gets a dot times 7. So for 7 days, 7 dots. And here you can put the days of the week. So let's say we're doing the first week of February. We'll put the dates, the 1st to the 7th, up above. So we've created a grid now. And then on the first day of February, we're gonna pretend, did I drink enough water? Did I go to the gym? Maybe I didn't take the time to journal, so I won't put a square in there. And I just wanted to play around with different ways that you could potentially mark these things off. So you can use a marker, you can use a pen. There's all sorts of ways to keep track. It just depends what you think looks the nicest. And then of course, you can always add some dainty leaves to dress up your tracker. Now, I think the other weekly daily one is pretty self-explanatory, but just in case you're wondering how I created it, and this is not my design, this is something I saw on Instagram or Pinterest, but I think it's a great design. All it is, you know, you put the 5 days of the week. Plus, I just do a W for weekend. And then you're going to do three areas here, all filled in gray. And that just helps to create five areas. And then you can put the five things that are most important to you. Of course, you could do six or seven or whatever. Mark a little line there. And that's all there is to it. It'll be interesting to see how my habit tracking goes in early February because we're traveling to Paris, so I'm sure I won't be, you know, keeping all my good habits, but I'm gonna try my best. So this one, I will begin February 1st, even though I'll be on a plane that day. Now I'm gonna flip a couple pages because these are all the pages I'm saving for my February weekly layouts. I'm gonna flip to the back of my February month, and I am gonna do one more tracker, and this is my fasting tracker. So Chris and I have recently gotten into intermittent fasting. We're like serious biohackers over here. We want to live our very best life. So actually, we always have fun playing around with different things. We love trying this and that. You know, one year it was I didn't buy any new clothes. I just shopped thrift, or we will go without TV, or we'll, you know, try this or that. So we're always trying something new. But anyways, right now we're all about that fasting, and it's just about not eating and putting your body into this fasting state for a few hours each day. So what we do is we eat from 11 till 7 every day, and the rest of the day, the other 16 hours are a fast. So I want to keep track of that. What I've done is I've written the hours of the day from 6 till 6 or 6 till 5 across the top. Days of the week are down the side. And then what I'm going to do is treat it like a sleep tracker and just track what hours of the day I did eat. So from 11 to 7, 11 till 7, and all the rest I haven't eaten. And then we always do one 24-hour fast on Monday. So Sunday night till Monday night, I wouldn't eat at all. And then we would eat at 7 on a Monday. Of course, then we allow ourselves to eat all that night and through the next day. So that's the difference you see there. But I mean, that's not really the important bit of this. I just wanted to show you guys that you can really track anything you can think of. I've seen so many great trackers on Pinterest and Instagram. I ended up just doing that in pencil so that I could actually use it come February. And these ones were sort of my little fake ones that I hope you found helpful to see how you might approach some different healthy trackers. Thanks so much for watching today, guys. Remember to watch the February 2019 plan with me if you haven't seen it already, and I will see you soon with a new tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe.